let's focus on some of the other major topics for discussion. Now here we will first start with methane hydrate. We have recently found in lots of deposits in the regions of Krishna Godavari. Methane hydrate is also called as biogenic methane. Now, important to note, this methane is interlocked in water molecules, and therefore, if it is drilled and exposed, it can lead to escape of methane into atmosphere, leading to global warming and severe temperature rises. So it is very important to handle this methane hydrate very, very properly, since it's a crystalline solid which is enclosed in a cage of water molecule. How we focus on it is important. Also, if there are low level of oxygen conditions which are there, the methanogens are the microorganisms that can help in production of methane hydrate, and methane could go as a byproduct in this process, and therefore methanogens produce the biogenic methane have been identified, and they are also the source of energy generation and have been very, very important. Now this energy which can be generated from methane hydrate can be used. Krishna Godavari plain or basin area has been identified as one of the major areas. Now this basin has been important. Around 5 kilometers of thickness of the sediment has been seen. This basin is home to olive riddle turtles, one of the most important species which we have been often talking about, a mass nesting site, and they are also classified under the vulnerable category of IUCN classification. The next is Amnesty International. Amnesty International is an independent body and recently has brought in allegations of human rights violation in the Northeast Delhi riots which had happened. Amnesty International in India has been playing an important role with a registered office at Bangalore. It has been awarded Nobel Peace Prize in 1997 and has been working as an NGO from London, the headquarters based in London. The next is Harit Mobile App. Now, Harit Mobile App aims at creating green highways across India. So, within a period of 25 days, 25 lakh trees were planted, and this was an initiative of Harit Bharat Sangh, where we were focusing on highway contracts and building in greenery along the highways. The next is Dare to Dream. Now, Dare to Dream is an innovation contest which has been released by DRDO, and this was on the death anniversary of Dr. Kalam. The idea is to promote startups and innovators to think and to bring in challenges for new ideas, mainly in two sectors, defense and aerospace technology. The award would be around 10 lakh for startups and 5 lakhs for individuals. The next is Bethynomus rhaxis. Now this is an isopod species which has been discovered, and this is interestingly called as cockroach of sea. Now while discovering the Indian Ocean, the bottom of the Indian Ocean in the Banten area near West Java, Indonesia, a team of researchers identified this isopod species. This isopod species is very, very unique because it lives in the sea bottom, even in the deserts of the sea bottom and the mountains of the sea bottom, and can reach up to 50 centimeters, and therefore are also called as super giants. These are some of the largest isopods which have been discovered, and they are scavengers. They eat only dead marine organisms. They can survive for very long period even if they do not get any food to eat. The next is Blackrock Android malware. Now this is a Trojan which is of the family of Xeris malware and is a variant of Lokibot Android Trojan. Now this comes as an update from Google. So this malware uses the Android device policy controller, and it provides access and permissions to others. It collects the information by abusing the accessibility server of the Android, and gives a fake screen overlay which is similar to a genuine app, then creates a keylogger which identifies your key logs, and this can hack your financial information as well. However, BlackRock is targeted for non-financial apps despite the fact that it is a banking trojan, an important malware on computers. What are trojans? What are malwares? We have viruses on computers. We have covered in a separate lecture. The next is PL Pro. PL Pro is one of the major immune response thing that we have talked about. It's a protein which suppresses the development of type 1 interferon. Now the cell mechanism gets hijacked, and therefore human cells try to fight back the human cells which produce the PLPRO, and therefore helps in replication of the virus. This has been important under the COVID-19. The next is Madhuban Gajar. Now, farmers from Junagadh, nearly 150 farmers in Gujarat, have come up and benefited through this biofortified carrot that they have been growing in the name of Madhuban Gajar. This Gajar variety was initially started by Sri Vallabhbhai Vasram Bhai Manvariya, and he is one of the scientists, farmer scientists from Junagadh, Gujarat, and he has been bestowed the National Award by President of India for his innovation. Value added products have come up from this carrot, which are mainly in the form of carrot chips, juice and pickles. It has higher beta carotene content and has now been popularly grown in most of the areas of Maharashtra, Rajasthan, West Bengal and Uttar Pradesh. The Festival of Innovation Award, which has been bestowed to Vasram Bhai, has been important because this was initially known as Festival of Innovation and Entrepreneurship and is an initiative of President of India to recognize grassroots level innovations in India. The fortification is the process where we are adding essential micronutrients in the food, and this Madhuban Gajar is a biofortified carrot where we are improving the nutritional quantity with higher beta carotene, as we said. The next is the pomelo trees. Now, pomelo is one of the huge citrus fruits, bigger than the oranges, and Devanahalli pomelo trees have been important. Devanahalli is the place where you have the new airport track that is to be identified. But at the same place, Devanahalli, this pomelos have been given the GI tag. So they are locally called as chakotas, and these have been important because these grapefruits have very high quantity of vitamin C, are also known as citrus maxima, and they can grow up to 25 inches in one season, reaching to a height of 25 feet. They can live from 50 to 150 years, with an average tree yielding around 400 pomelos, each fruit of about 2 to 2.5 kgs. Now, with the development of the airport in the Devanahalli areas of Bangalore, this requires a shift, and also there has been an absence of organized market, and therefore we have seen decline in the Devanahalli pomelos recently. The next is the strategic reserves for petroleum in India. Now, petroleum, we have three important strategic crude oil storage locations. Those are in Visakhapatnam, Mangaluru and Padur. Padur and Mangaluru, both in Karnataka. And then we also have an important facility at Chandikhol in Odisha. These are all strategic reserves which are maintained by the strategic crude oil storage facilities under Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Here, underground storage has been taken into account. The next is exercise Pitch Black 2020. This was cancelled after the COVID. And here, the Royal Australian Air Force host this pitch black exercise, and it makes sure that Air Force has the ability to conduct operations with the integration. So it's a kind of defense cooperation between nations and has been important. Legion of Merit has been awarded by United States to the Prime Ministers of India, Japan and Australia. The four countries have been playing an important role in revival of a quadrilateral group since 2017 in order to curb the growing dominance of China. So this Legion of Merit was instituted in 1942 and since then has been awarded to people outside United States. These could be chief commanders, commanders, officers, Field Marshal Kariappa and General SM Sri Nagesh have been awarded this award. Now the next is Kartarpur Sahib. Very, very important. Kartarpur Sahib is located very, very close to Dera Baba Nanak. Now Kartarpur Sahib lies presently in Pakistan, the Narwal district. Narwal district in Pakistan has to be connected with Dera Baba Nanak in India. This is a small passage which has been declared visa free. So that means you can go to that part of Pakistan and come back without a visa. And this Kartarpur corridor has been built in 2019. As per historians, it was that Guru Nanak Dev arrived to Kartarpur and he spent his last 18 years of life there. And therefore, Kartarpur has been very, very important in Sikhism. Now, this visa-free movement has indeed brought a great tourism to the two areas. The next is Dobra Chatni Bridge. Dobra Chanti Bridge is one of the suspension bridges which have been laid down in the Tehri Garhwar area in Uttar Pradesh. It is the longest motorable single lane suspension bridge, which is nearly 440 meters long. Now, this would bring in more tourism, more connectivity, and boost local employment. It originates in the Garhwal area and is on the Bhagirathi River. So, Bhagirathi River reaches here. And this is also close to the Tehri Dam. Now, Tehri Dam is the fourth highest dam in the world and the highest dam in India, located in the Tehri district, and it's again on the river Bhagirathi, important for providing irrigation and electricity purpose. The next is Yanomami tribe. Now, the Yanomami tribe is an important tribe, the relatively most isolated tribe in the world in South America, in the regions of Brazil and Venezuela. Now, they live in Llanos. Each house can have nearly 400 people. They are circular houses which are there. And the Right Livelihood Award was given to a Brazilian indigenous leader of this tribe for conserving and protecting the tribes. There are popular other tribes of the Amazon Basin which have been marked here. And as per Survival International, which is an international human rights organization advocacy based in London, which campaigns for the indigenous rights of the locals and the tribals across the globe, Yanomami is one of the important tribes which have been taken. The next is a very important thing, which is Nazca Lines. Now, Nazca Lines has geoglyphs. Geoglyphs have been discovered at the sites in Peru, and these are imaginary depictions of huge, large size animals which remained on earth. Now, these geoglyphs are seen on the land. They could be largest archaeological enigma in terms of the continuity and the vastness. As you can see, this diagram shows a pelican, a condor and a monkey together. So there have been similar geoglyphs which have been seen as a part of archaeological excavations, and they are variety of shapes which have been discovered there. These were discovered in 1927 and have been declared as World Heritage Site by UNESCO. The cat geoglyph is again one of the important geoglyphs which has been prior to the Nazca Lines, and the Parca sculpture, which is the existing present day Parcas Desert, is an important constituent of this region. The next is International Press Institute. Now, this highlights the exemption of freedom from the punishment that has resulted in increasing crime against journalists. The government has not been able to go into details. So, some of the highlights related to IPI have been mentioned. It is based in Vienna and has been having a list of global editors and networks working together. Green Corridor. Now, this is an important corridor where we say there is unrestricted movement of human organs. Let's say a person needs a heart transplant in Delhi and the heart has to come from Bangalore. So through this green corridor, there would be no signals, no traffic congestion, and an unrestricted movement from Bangalore to Delhi. Now, this has to be developed in lines and procedures laid down by National Organ and Tissue Transplant Organization. The idea is that the transplant organ should reach safely and timely, and also with proper surveillance. Also, the post transport or the transplant survival rate of the patients need to be taken into account in order to determine which areas can be connected and how far the organ can travel. The next is the Pulikali folk art. Now, Pulikali is a folk art from Kerala. Puli means leopard, Kali means a play in Malayalam. Now, these are the street folk arts that have been played during the Onam celebration on the fourth day of Onam. The dance had been introduced by Thampuran, and he was one of the Maharajas of Cochin. The art is very, very famous in the Thrissur area of Kerala. The performers paint their body similar to a tiger, and then they dance like hunters. There are hunters, and it's a dance on the street where all the local traditions are brought into play. Also, boat race, the Aranmula boat race is part of it, and this is one of the oldest boat race festivals in Kerala. The next is Bharati script. Again, a very, very important development that has been done, and this talks about a common script which can understand all set of letters: Devanagari, Roman, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, Gujarati, Bengali. And this is a very simple script which has been developed by a team of students from IIT Madras under Professor Srinivas Chakravarti. This is a simple unified script which can be used for writing all Indian languages. So the idea is one nation, one script. Roman script, Devanagari script, and the local scripts can also be added into it. This is highly useful for migrants traveling from one state to another state who find difficulty in comprehending the native scripts. So with the help of this Bharat script, this can become much more easier. The next is Kogex 2020. This is a festival of artificial intelligence and emerging technologies with the best innovation award for COVID-19 under the People's Choice category that has been given. And MyGov Corona Help Desk has been bringing this in line where what kind of artificial intelligence and emerging technologies can be used to fight this issue. The next is Kohala Hydropower Project. Now, under the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, this project has been set up. India has been constantly raising objections regarding this project. It is said to be built upon Jhelum River and is nearly 124 megawatt project, which would be built up, and Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh would be affected. So it is, India has already raised issues regarding the Demar Bhasha Dam, which we had already discussed in our previous section, and this is the next one where we have controversies which have been raised. The next is Nagarvan scheme. Now, Nagarvan scheme aims to develop the forest areas mainly in the urban areas. So 200 urban forests would be developed under the Nagarvan scheme. Now, Varje urban forest area in Pune has been created as a role model, and there have been numerous other fundings which would be done by KAMPA, which is Compensatory Afforestation Fund, and this would be managed by the authorities, and this compensatory fund would be given every time when the forest is diverted for the non-forest activities. Payment for planting the forest would be the responsibility of the user agency, and this has to be taken into account. The next is in the Rhine Valley. Rhine Valley is one of the major valleys that drain the regions of Germany. We have seen that the water levels have been significantly dropping. In 2020 April itself, 40% water level dropped. Global warming and distribution of glacier have been important and affecting it. Groundwater levels have further gone down in Germany because of the heat levels, and we have also seen a second longest impact that has been seen mainly in the various countries. Now, Rhine, as we know, is one of the major rivers of Central and Western Europe. It lies its origin in the Swiss Alps and runs through the various areas. India has recently come up with Arogya Path. It is an information portal released by Government of India for real-time healthcare services for manufacturers and suppliers. There have been various key points associated to it, and it focuses on any anticipated shortage that can be seen. Arogyapath has come up with CSIR initiative and has got first rank in Nature Ranking Index 2020. The next is Exxon, which is a soybean cuisine of Northeast India. Exxon is nothing but fermented soybean, and it's one of the most popular dishes being consumed by the tribals of Northeast India in Nagaland. It is also known as Akhuni. It is known for its unique flavor and smell, and is known by the Sumi tribes. Sumi tribes enjoy this delicacy, which is the fermented soybean. Now, Sumi tribe are also known as the Seba tribe. They lie in the ethnic areas and certain pockets of Nagaland. Tinsukia in Assam also have 7 different Sumi villages, and therefore the Exxon is one of the delicacies there as well. The next is the ATDS system, very, very important for defense. Advanced Torpedo Defense System, also called as MARICH. This was inducted to Indian Navy and is capable of being fired from all frontline ships. Now, DRDO has developed MARICH and has been capable of understanding the intricacies. The production system comes with the Bharat Electronics Limited, and it detects, diffuse and diverts the torpedo attacks on the ship under water as well. So this is very, very significant. It is self-propelled and can be used over the water, under the water. The next is Vande Bharat Mission. Vande Bharat Mission was the mission through which we were trying to bring the people back to India who were stuck in foreign nations. Now, Operation Samudra Setu was through the sea bridge, where we have launched Indian Navy to bring people back. Through both of these, we were able to bring a lots of people back to India. Through the Operation Samudra Setu, under two ships, INS Jalashwa and INS Magar, we were able to bring citizens back to India. Now, a similar thing happened during the Gulf War. During the Gulf War, nearly 177,000 Indian citizens were stranded in the Gulf areas, and due to the hostility that arose between the regions of Kuwait and Iraq, people had to be brought back to India, and there were a similar mission that was done during this time. The next is Parkinson's. Now, this is a neurological disorder where nerve cells in the brain gets damaged and is governed, usually related to aging or geriatric problems. So, as aging occurs, Parkinson's, the severity increases. Now, the level of the dopamine significantly decreases. Dopamine is a chemical that sends signals from the brain to the body to perform certain actions. As a result, our muscle movements are done. With the reduction of the dopamine, this muscle movements gets out of control. There are delayed movements, poor balances and tremors which are seen. Usually, people about 60 years start to witness symptoms of Parkinson's, and it is a neurodegenerative disorder which degenerates on a regular basis. Nearly 10 million people worldwide have been affected by Parkinson's. The next is National Biomedical Resource Indigenization Consortium. Now, this talks about the reagents which have been used for developing vaccines or therapies for COVID-19, and this has come up as an effort from CCMB, the Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology, and their state-of-art technologies for bringing that into action. The next is Missile Park Agni Prashasth. Missile Park Agni Prashasth has been laid down by INS Kalinga. INS Kalinga has been important. It is one of the premier naval establishments located at the Vishakhapatnam beach under the Eastern Naval Command segment. And the entire segment is a replica of missile and ground support equipments. Agni Prashasth is a one-stop place where students or children can come to naval persons and understand how it works and how it functions. So this has been a real development. The next is an interesting illegal software named as Real Mango. Now, Real Mango is a software which has been developed to basically hijack the real-time Tatkal booking systems in railways. So in the railways, if let's say I am traveling on an urgent basis and I cannot get a reservation, I need to get my tickets done on an urgent basis as a Tatkal system. Now, this Real Mango software, what it does is it books the Tatkal Tatkal seats, so no Tatkal seats available for common people. So it bypasses the CAPTCHA system and it synchronizes your system with the bank OTP, and therefore multiple IRTC's IDs have been generated and the software locks into the IRCTC website, and therefore multiple tickets are booked by the agent simultaneously. So all the Tatkal tickets are being booked by the agents, leaving no tickets for the common man, and this is a illegal software that was determined. And CAPTCHA is a system through which we identify this is non machine. So CAPTCHA, the word itself means completely automated public Turing test to tell computer and humans apart. So let's say in the CAPTCHA you would be given 2 plus 8, so you do not know what the next CAPTCHA would be as an image, and it would be only human who would be able to read and identify, let's 2 plus 8 is 10 and write 10 there. So that is what is CAPTCHA. The next is GOAL program. GOAL is the ongoing online as leaders program. Now this is an initiative of Facebook and Ministry of Tribal Affairs to bring in digital literacy and awareness in the tribal pockets, how we can help the common tribal people with food processing, beekeeping, tribal art, tribal culture. The next is online Nishtha program. Now this is a national initiative for school heads and teachers holistic advancement. It is a kind of online teachers training program. Now this has been started completely online by the state of Andhra Pradesh. It was launched in 2019 as a face-to-face program, and then slowly it was translated into an online program where learning outcomes, school-based outcomes have been evaluated, and new initiatives in education and training programs to teachers are given under this initiative, and this has been released under Ministry of Human Resource Development, now Ministry of Education. The next is Sonic Boom. A sonic boom was heard in the regions of Bangalore. This created sound waves or shock waves. Usually sonic booms are created when a plane goes at a speed of more than 1225 kilometers per hour at the sea level. Such high speed can create shock waves on earth and could lead to bigger and heavier movements of the thing. Now the reason for this sonic boom production has not been explained, however their impacts were seen and have been noticed. The next is quantum entanglement. Now quantum entanglement basically says that if there are two particles located far apart, the spin of each of the particle is random, but if we are able to identify the spin of one of the particle, we can identify the spin of the other particle which is entangled to the first particle, and with the help of this we can do a real time interaction between the two particles, or the real time understanding between the two particles. Recently, a device independent self-testing method has been developed by S.N. Bose National Center for Basic Sciences based in Kolkata to identify or to find out whether a pair of electrons were in an entangled state or not. So that has been another important development that we have witnessed. We would be covering one more session on environment and basic highlights, important topics related to environment. Stay tuned for updates for the important and expected topics. We would be meeting you soon again. Have a wonderful day ahead.